We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we are talking ping irons. Now, lots has changed with ping irons over the last 18 months. We've seen a new i59, new i230, new i525, and now we've got a new ping G430. So now seems the perfect time to see if we can show you how all of the new models compare and see if we can help you choose which model will suit you. So let's get started with the newest model, Neil, the G430.
Yeah. Hell of a lot of technology in here to cover, Simon. Obviously, let's start with a little bit thinner face, heat treated face, a little bit thinner, going to relate to a little bit more ball speed for the golfer.
So they can strengthen the steel so that the face can be thinner and still stand up to impact.
And stand up at impact, yeah. Okay. A little bit more compact looking, so when you look at it at address, looks a little bit smaller than the 425. It is a better looking iron than last year's model, in my opinion. Even looks at, like, when it, if it sits in the golf bag, very clever, slick design. Nice how they've got the badging on the back there. Obviously, weight port out towards the toe to bring that just CG across.
Just worth just pointing out, you know, the G-irons, they've evolved, haven't they?
Huge.
So since the first model, 2004, they've got better and better looking.
Used to be very boxy,
really,
didn't
boxy and long.
Yeah, and now they're getting a little bit more rounded, a bit more compact. They are getting better looking, more pleasing on the eye to dress, aren't they?
Okay, and what really intrigues me is this new flexible badge.
Yeah, you know, unbelievable.
So what Ping is saying is that the badge can actually restrict face flex. So rather than coming up with a cat-back design or a hollow body construction, what they've done is make sure that the badge actually flexes with the iron. So it's a multi-piece badge. Which is a really different idea. 15 different areas to it, 15 sort of different parts.
Amazing technology. Even looking at it there, Sammy, you can see, can't you, the construction in there, how it's not all one piece. Because I'm guessing if that was just one piece, it'd probably shatter.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So splitting it down into the three areas gives it that flexibility.
Mm-hmm.
Going to act like a little bit of a trampoline effect, really, to maintain some ball speed.
Yeah, I really like the idea that it improves sound and feel, but it encourages the face to flex at the same time.
Yeah.
You know, that sounds like a really, really good story to me. And then more bounce.
Yeah.
So the type of player that would tend to buy the G-iron, they will have the tendency quite often to hit sort of heavy fat shots now and again, not always.
Yeah.
So just by having 1 degree more bounce, it's like an insurance policy. About, you know, sort of digging straight in the turf, you know, hitting really heavy iron shots.
And then the final two things which I really like, Simon. So they've lowered MOI, but better dispersion because of bringing the CG down a little bit. Majority of golfers tend to hit low on the face, so it's given them a little bit more tighter dispersion with the miss hits.
Yeah, so it's almost like they've brought the centre of gravity to the golfer.
Yeah.
If lots of shots are hit low on the face, why not put the centre of gravity there?
Yeah, which is really, really clever. Make the game, like we've discussed before, with loads of different irons, just make the game as easy as possible can.
Okay.
And this new high launch setup I really like. Again, it's a trend that we're seeing from all the leading manufacturers at the minute, aren't we, Simon?
Yeah.
And just to weaken a few things off, get it a little bit weaker in loft, a little bit lighter in the shaft, just so people could swing it. The guy who swings it a little bit slower can swing it a bit quicker, get the golf ball to hit the correct peak height, correct descent angle they're looking for.
So the loft hasn't changed at all, but they're just making it 15% lighter across the whole family, so that you can just launch it, you know, at lower speed. So lots of different options there. Let's have a look at some of the lofts, because the lofts have been strengthened a fraction compared to the previous model.
So now we're on, obviously, 7-iron would be 29 now, obviously. So 1 degree stronger than the G425, the previous model. But like I just said there, you've got a retro spec and a power spec.
Mm-hmm.
So you can take the 7-iron, obviously, to 31. Mm-hmm. Or 27.5 if you wanted to, which is quite strong, isn't it, Simon? So if you're somebody who adds quite a bit of dynamic loft and you're increasing the loft at impact, you can strengthen it out a little bit as well.
And just really important to not be put off by that strong loft.
Yeah.
You know, I've heard from Ping a number of times now, don't be put off by it, because they have got the centre of gravity low, and you might well see later when you see our data, you know, about how this strong loft iron is still going to launch shots up there, you're still going to spin it, you're still going to be able to stop it as well. Okay, so let's just run through the family, you know, because there's a few different models here.
Yeah, definitely. Let's start with Blueprint. Now, Very small, small profile, tiny looking, not huge amount of forgiveness in there, Simon. So we've got it obviously as a muscle back blade, forgiveness rating 1 out of 5. Traditional lofted, 34 degrees, so quite high loft, handicap range 4 and below. Again, like you see from a lot of blades, one piece forged. You're just putting everything on the line using that. Don't get me wrong, phenomenal looking golf club, yeah. But not one I'd put in many golfers' hands.
And the soles have got to be the thinnest in any iron in the market.
It's
a scary
definitely,
thing,
definitely.
Okay, so Ping I-59, player's iron.
Yeah, player's iron.
Rammed full of technology.
Loads in there, yeah. So you could obviously, forged. I've got your forged in there. Forgiveness rating 2 out of 5. Again, 34 in terms of the loft. So again, traditional lofted. Handicap range, and remember the handicap is only a guide. We understand that some guys strike it better than the handicap suggests. But 6 and below, a little bit hollow body construction in there. Mm-hmm. So I'd expect to see a little bit more ball speed over this than the blueprint. Mm-hmm. But again, not much forgiveness there, but probably a little bit more workability.
Okay, so then we start to move into the realms of more club golfers here, I'd say.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is still a player's iron,
yeah,
but it's a little bit more playable than some.
Starting with your, I'd say, better players and for the club golfer, should we say, that this would be the brink where I'd put the club golfer could put this to the test. Mm-hmm. Fantastic looking golf club, the I-230. Really slick design. Player's iron, 2.5 out of 5 on the forgiveness there. Loft at 33, again, so strong by no means, no means of the imagination. Handicap range 10 and below. One piece cast in terms of the construction.
But you would say the feel is pretty good from them because of the elastomer going
out the hole. Yeah. I think from when I've tested them in the past, I mean, if you were to say to me they were forged, I couldn't tell the difference really. They do feel soft.
Okay. And then the 525. So this is where it becomes more about distance.
Yeah.
Players distance iron.
You start to get
still
a bit
really good looking iron.
Yeah, good looking iron. You get a little bit more speed now. Obviously players distance iron, 2.5 out of 5 on the rating. 30.5 on the loft, so we're starting to get a little bit stronger now. Handicap range 12 and below, and obviously your hollow-bodied construction in there. Forge face, weight port in the toe to bring that CG across. So plenty of technology in there.
Okay, and then at the top of the range,
here we go. Yeah,
we've got the G430.
Yeah.
So this is aimed at a huge audience.
Huge audience, yeah. I think we've got it down as mid to high handicap iron. It can be used throughout, really. Mm-hmm. Especially with manipulation in those lofts there, that's something that people need to pay attention to. Obviously 3.5 out of 5 on the forgiveness rating. As a standard off the shelf, we're seeing 29 degree loft, which is 1 degree stronger than previous 425 model. Handicap range 8 and above. Construction in there, obviously cast body with your hyper face in there.
Okay, and if you're a slow swing speed player, don't think there's nothing in the range for you because you have got the high launch model that we've already covered. Okay, and then just to show the options that are available,
loads,
Ping
aren't
are
they?
A custom fit brand, aren't they?
Got loads there, haven't we? Dynamic Gold, AWT, Alta CB, there's recoils in there, Modus are in there, there's plenty of options there for you to try, and fantastic lineup in the grip thickness as well.
Okay, and then where do they all sit in the family? That's a really, really simple graph for you to be able to see.
Yeah, obviously distance for the guys can see up the left, and then obviously your forgiveness from less to more, working from obviously your G430 right the way down to your blueprint.
Right, I think it's time to get out. Let's go and hit some shots and then we'll come back and we'll show you how all these models compare in terms of data. Right, Neil, 5 irons, how do they compare?
Yep.
This is a really interesting place to start, I think, is at the bottom. Okay,
yep.
It's G430 because it is a stronger loft, so you do get more ball speed.
Yeah.
But what really stands out to me is that we're looking at a really high peak height and a decent descent angle.
Yeah.
So
I think, bearing in mind, we haven't manipulated anything here in terms of it fitting my game. Obviously, it's quite strong loft. I think if we were to weaken the loft off, it would perform even better because I'd stabilise the spin a little bit more. However, still getting a great peak height and great descent angle because it's quite high on the ball speed, you see. Mm-hmm. So I dare say, because I've got probably slightly above average speed, club speed this being, I'm probably getting away with it a little bit more. I think with your slower swing speed, he's not going to get the height out of it with that sort of loft.
Okay. So for the vast majority of golfers, they would want to not give up any distance at all.
No.
So long as you get the right setup,
yeah.
that iron can work for you, even though it's a strong loft.
Yeah, definitely. I think from what we can see, if we're talking about distance, I mean, I'm happy in the terms of, I would expect to see Blueprint being the shortest, mm-hmm. right the way through to the 430 being the longest. Great. Mm-hmm. Great numbers for myself, personally, from Blueprint to I-59. Yeah, but I dare say for a club golfer, it's going to be minimal that fall into that category. We'll be looking I-230, I-525 and G-430 for your club golfer. Okay. Now, another thing what people will pick up on, I'm 19 yards longer with the G-430 than I am with the I-230. I'm not saying that you're going to get that sort of gain or it's a great gain, but you need to test these for yourself. Yeah, don't get me wrong. For me personally, the I-230 is the best iron out of the lineup. It mm-hmm. feels great. I love the soft feel out the way that it looks. Okay. I could probably use any of those irons in this category. If the golfer's looking for a little bit of forgiveness with all that technology in there, look at the G430 and look at manipulating those lofts, a little bit lighter, changing in shafts, loads of things that you can do there to really help maximise your golf game.
Okay, so I think we're on the same wavelength. That for the vast majority of golfers, you can take out the Blueprint.
Definitely.
Take out the I-59 because they're not really irons that are aimed at the average club golfer.
Yep.
Then start looking at I-230, okay? If you've got any concerns around your own game about not losing any distance, then that's not the right iron for you.
No.
If you want a great looking iron that's a player's iron, then it is a great iron. But if you need to keep an eye on distance, you've got to be looking at I-525 or then the G-430.
I think the G-430 is a fantastic iron. All that technology that was in there felt good, it looked compact. I feel like a lot of the club golfers going to get best of both worlds. Like I've just said, compact looking, not huge amount of offset, but forgiving.
Brilliant. Okay, well, there's a lot of information in there. If you've liked the video, hit the like and subscribe button. And if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below. And we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.